check out this video. It is hard to watch. Surveillance videos of a family's home in Bakersfield, California. You can see that dog checking out what's going on at the neighbor. He sees a kid on a bike, and for a few seconds, he heads around that car, decides to come upon that boy and attack the child, drag the child. Ah, look at that. The cat, the family's cat named Tara, comes to the rescue, chases the dog off, darting onto the screen, knocking that dog away, saving that little boy. Yes, I said cat. It's unbelievable. I'm glad to report that boy is okay, but he did have a couple of stitches. And the mom is saying that the dog belongs to a neighbor and that that dog is now under observation. Joining me to talk about this, CNN commentator and lawyer Mel Robbins, as well as CNN legal analyst Danny Savalos. Danny, first to you, what does under observation mean? Meaning that dog is a goner.
I think we're going to see the same fate that befell old Yeller. I think this is this cat dog is probably doomed. The cat, I suppose, is a hero, although at the same time, who knows? I often think the cats just wish they were as big as us to eat us, but
well,
Mel and I disagree on that.
He's a cat hater.
Yeah, I don't know.
When I look at that unprovoked attack on a child, when I look at that, it reminded me of the exposure legally that a California dog owner had, charged with manslaughter after the death because of that dog owner's mauling of a neighbor. I mean, could this dog owner be charged with any kind of assault?
Should be.
So under California Penal Code Section 399, if your dog seriously causes bodily injury to another person, you can be guilty of either a misdemeanor or a felony. But the key is whether or not you had notice. You knew that your dog had abnormally dangerous propensity. So that's a tough one.
Yeah.
Or, as California defines it, if your animal is mischievous. What that exactly means is probably to be determined by a court.
Right.
But they will look at whether or not this dog has bitten somebody before.